27-year-old female infected with unknown pathogen. Blood analysis indicates virus. Provisional name is Pax-12. Cause of death appears to be catastrophic organ failure.
Here we're going to start in the UK. This is where our pathogen begins its outbreak. The aim of the game is to infect everybody with your disease and eventually wipe out the whole world before humanity can cure it. So it's not a particularly nice game. As the player starts the game, the disease is very weak, but then as the player continues to play, they gain DNA points and they're able to spread the disease around the world more. Eventually, the world will notice that this disease is spreading and then begin to respond in order to develop a cure. There's a very fine line, or a very important line rather, that we need to take between real world suffering and a fictitious game. And for us, it's very important to keep those two elements very separate. It's not nice. We've made a game which is now 8 years old. In those 8 years, there have been multiple times when a dangerous or concerning disease has emerged. What we see a lot of on social media is people talking about, oh, this situation reminds me of Plague Inc. On one hand, you'd rather that this whole situation wasn't happening at all, but then at the same time, it's still good to feel that people are able to learn something from our game and use that to try and handle what's a very scary situation in the real world. What we try to do is help raise awareness of what's going on and make sure that people aren't getting deceived by various rumours that are spreading around. When Ebola was causing a concern back in 2014, we did a charity drive with our players. The campaign was Ebola is not a game, and we directed players from all around the world to their local charity so that they could donate to those charities helping to combat Ebola. It's very unpleasant, but it's something which allows dialogue between people when often there might not be dialogue otherwise.